Hello learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. Myself, Ruchi Dubey, Assistant Professor, Department of Education, University of Allahabad. Today, I'll be discussing the topic Moral Development. Now, the question arises that what is moral development? For understanding the moral development, we have to first know what is the meaning of the word moral. The word moral is derived from a Latin word mores, which means manners, customs, or folkways. Moral development is one of the most important developmental dimensions of human being. Moral development means the ability to discriminate between what is right and what is wrong, what is good and what is bad, and to do behavior accordingly. Thus, moral development means moral behavior, and it is an essential quality of the total personality of the individual. Moral behavior means behavior which is in conformity with the moral code of the social group. The child has to learn what is good and what is bad, what is right and what is wrong. The child has also to learn his duty. It means that morality is linked with the social relationship and the social process. In short, it can be said that morality is linked with the social system of an individual. Human beings are neither moral or immoral by birth. Their moral behavior is molded by the parents, friends, relatives, neighbors, classmates, members of the society, as well as by the teachers. Moral development includes characteristics of honesty, truthfulness, trustworthiness, self-respect, respect of elders, righteousness, self-control, duty consciousness, compassion in the child. According to Zandon, 1978, moral development refers to a process by which children adopt principles that lead them to evaluate given behaviors as right and wrong, and to govern their own action in terms of their principles. Barron, 2001, defined moral development as changes in the capacity to reason about rightness or wrongness of various actions that occur with age. Moral development can be said that it is a process through which children develop proper attitude and behavior towards other people in the society based on social and cultural norms, rules and laws. Thus, we can say that in moral development, a child learns the rules and laws of the society, which helps him to differentiate between right and wrong behavior. Rules and laws learned in the moral development determines the behavior of the person, and process of moral development gets strengthened with the increase in age. Next, we come to the features of moral development. Actually, the features of moral development are different in different stages. In infancy, the features of child moral development are: at the time of birth, the child is neither moral or immoral. His moral self is developed as a result of sanctions and punishments provided by the parents. In schools, teachers develop desirable conduct through approval or disapproval of their behavior and by providing worth experiences. During childhood, the features of moral development are: the peer group plays a very important role in developing moral behavior in childhood. Secondly, moral behavior is strengthened by the reward and punishment received by parents and teachers. And thirdly, children follow the social and cultural norms and codes. Now, the next thing we have to discuss in moral development is the dimensions or components of moral development. Actually, there are three dimensions of moral development. The first is the emotional dimension, the second, behavioral dimension, and the third is the cognitive dimension. Now we'll be discussing these dimensions in detail. Now, first thing is emotional dimension. Emotional component or emotional dimension is one of the most important dimension of moral development because it is the emotion or the feelings of a person which make him realize the sorrow of others and to feel guilty if he himself is the reason of sorrow of others. The second is the behavioral dimension. It is the second important dimension of moral development and it refers to behavior and its consequences. The consequences of behavior done by the child motivates him to learn moral values. For example, suppose if a child has done any moral behavior and he gets reward for that, then he will learn that behavior and it will lead to his moral development. And suppose if a child has done something immoral or he has done an immoral behavior and he gets punishment for that, then he will not try to do that immoral behavior again. The third is the cognitive dimension. If a child has a social understanding, then he can take correct decision about right and wrong behavior. Cognitive maturity and social experiences helps in the development of moral behavior. Thus, all the three dimensions, the emotional, the behavioral and the cognitive, all the three dimensions are interrelated. Next thing in moral development is the phases of moral development. Actually, moral development takes place in two phases. First is the development of moral behavior and the second is the development of moral concepts. Development of moral behavior. Actually, moral behavior means behaving in a socially approved manner. Children learn socially approved manner or behavior through direct teaching or through trial and error. The second phase is development of moral concepts. The second phase consists of learning of moral concepts or principles of right and wrong. Moral concepts actually reflects moral behavior. Now, further, we'll discuss about the elements of moral development. Actually, moral development is a slow and a long-term process which extends to adolescence. In learning to be moral, there are four essential elements. The first is learning what the social group expects of its members as laid in laws, customs, and rules. In every social group are certain rules, customs, and every member of the group are expected to follow them. These laws and rules are for the welfare of all. The second element is developing a conscience to act as an internal control over the individual's behavior. No child is born with morality or immorality, but they have to learn it by developing a conscience. They also have to use this conscience as a control over their behavior or as a guideline for their behavior. The third is learning to experience guilt and shame when the individual's behavior fails to conform to the expectations of the group. If a behavior done by a child is not in conformity with the set laws and rules of the society, the child feels guilt and shame. The fourth is having opportunity for social interactions to learn what members of the group expect. The child must get opportunity to interact with the members of the group. Social interaction plays a very important role in moral development. Social intelligence provides children the standard of socially approved behavior and it also provides them with a source of motivation. Social intelligence starts with the family. Child learns from parents, siblings, and family members the right social behavior. Next is the theories of moral development. There are various theories of moral development and we'll be discussing each one of them. The first is the psychoanalytical theory. It is given by Sigmund Freud. Freud believed that moral development of a child depends on his superego. Actually, Freud, in his theory of personality, said that personality has three parts: it, ego and superego. But he believed that for the moral development of a child, superego is more important. He regarded superego as a moral commander, which tells the individual about moral values, principles and moral standards. The second theory is the theory of Kohlberg. According to Lawrence Kohlberg's theory, moral development proceeds in sequential stages. This theory states that internal cognitive process like thinking and reasoning plays a major role in one's moral development. The way children can make moral judgment depends on their upbringing and learning experiences. Kohlberg, in his theory of moral development, states that there are three levels of moral development, and movement from one stage to another depends on cognitive abilities rather than acquisition of moral values from parents and elders or peers. Next is Piaget's view on moral development. According to Piaget, there are four stages of moral development of a child: anomy, heteronomy authority, heteronomy reciprocity, and autonomy. The anomy stage begins from 0 to 5 years. Heteronomy authority extends from 5 to 8 years, heteronomy reciprocity from 9 to 13 years, and autonomy from 13 to 18 years. Anomy. It is a stage without law. At this stage, the behavior of the child is neither moral or immoral, but actually it is non-moral. The behavior of the child is not guided by moral standards, but it is regulated by pain and pleasure. This means that at the anomy stage, that is, when a child is between 0 to 5 years, he is not guided by any moral standard, but his behavior is totally regulated by pain and pleasure. The child repeats the behavior which give him pleasure and avoid those which give him pain. The second stage is heteronomy authority. It is a stage in which the moral development is controlled by external authority. That is, someone external actually control his moral behavior. Moral development in this stage is regulated by rewards and punishment. It is also called the stage of discipline of artificial consequences imposed by adults. The third stage given by Piaget is heteronomy reciprocity. In this stage, moral behavior or moral development is regulated by reciprocity, which means that whatever is offensive to the child, he should not do to others. In this stage, conformity with the group becomes imperative. And the last stage is autonomy. It is also called the equity stage. In this stage, the moral behavior of the child depends on motive and circumstances. Individual controls his own behavior. The individual is responsible for his own behavior. Moral behavior at this stage is governed by the rules within the individual. The last is the social learning theory. It is given by Albert Bandura. Albert Bandura believed that just as a child learns other behavior, similarly, he learns moral behavior also. This theory states that moral behavior is learned by observation. When a child sees someone doing a behavior and getting a positive response as a consequence of that behavior, the child also, as a result, learns that behavior. Similarly, when a child sees the model doing a moral behavior, he also learns to do that moral behavior. Thus, it means that moral development depends on observation of moral behavior and imitation of that moral behavior. Moral development. Moral development of a child is dependent on various factors like physical and mental health, family environment, social influence, intelligence, etc. We'll be discussing each one of them in detail now. The first factor that influences moral development of a child is his physical and mental health. Health of an individual affects his moral behavior. Health of an individual also affects the point of view and ideals of life. A child with a sound health learns desirable behavior very fast. The second factor which influences the moral development is the family environment. Family environment is a very significant factor affecting the moral development. Moral views of the family members, parents, moral discipline among family members, lack of love and compensation among the family members, all these things influence the moral development of the child. Next is social influence. Child's moral development is also influenced by the society. Social influence includes society, friends, and group members. Child's moral behavior is influenced by the moral viewpoint of the group. Child's view regarding what is right and what is wrong to a great extent is controlled by the views of the group members. Next point is intelligence. Moral thinking and reasoning depends on intelligence. Higher the level of intellectual development or intelligence of an individual, higher will be his moral development. Another point which affects the moral development of a child is his religion. Actually, religion plays a very important role in moral development. All the religions emphasize on development of moral values. The more the child is committed towards his religion, the greater will be his moral development. Age is also a factor that affects moral development. Moral development increases as the age of a person increases. Gender. Gender of a person influences moral development, and it is generally said that as compared to boys, girls show better moral conduct. Another factor that influences the moral development of the child is the motivation. Moral behavior depends on the motivation level of the child. If a person has a high achievement need but fear of failure, then he commits immoral behavior like cheating. Beside these, there are few other factors that influence moral development, like the culture of the person, his socioeconomic status, experiences of life, rules and regulations of the community, sanctions and punishment given by elders, conscious training, moral reasoning, intellectual development. So, today we had studied about moral development, the concept of moral development, what actually moral development means, what are the phases of moral development, dimensions of moral development, elements of moral development. And we had discussed four theories of moral development. And lastly, we had discussed the factors influencing development. Thank you.